want to get into your muscles a little bit deep, a little bit heavy. We want to move them around pretty vigorously just to see if we can work some of these spasms out, okay? If it ever gets to be a little too vigorous, a little too hard, just let me know, okay? Whenever I settle in and start to give your muscles a shake, I won't give you more than like a 5 or a 6 count, okay?
Okay.
Tickles
a little.
Yeah, I know. You know, the same nerve endings that feel tickle is they're called nociceptors, and they're actually the nerve endings that detect pain and tell your brain that it hurts. So tickles and pain sensation can kind of come from the same place, same nerves.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
A little tiny bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
How's that feel?
Really good.
Oh, okay. Well, okay.
It feels like I've had so much pressure and like tightness there that when I do rub it, I can't feel it.
Yeah, I know. You need to really like, I know what you're talking about because I try to get back here too. Like it gets really, really tight. You have to press so hard to just like affect some kind of a response.
I got a tennis ball that I was trying to use off of the video that I saw. That's interesting.
You were trying to use a tennis ball.
Mm-hmm. You put it on your back and lay on the ground and put your feet up.
Uh-huh.
And it's interesting to watch me do it, but it's the only time I can feel it, you know?
Yeah, so it's actually doing a little bit for you then?
Yeah.
Okay. There's,
I have the tension, which I keep forgetting to bring.
Oh, yeah, we're going to do that. Mm-hmm.
Which I finally got it to work on. I put it down my left side of my back,
mm-hmm.
and I could feel it working, and it was moving my muscles by itself, so it's like, okay, that's cool.
Okay. Yeah, that's kind of a mood too. That kind of helps like with like muscle strength whenever you like have an injury or something like that. The electric current will help you contract against weights or something like that if you're trying to like rehab your muscles like that.
I'm not sure how this actually even happened. Other than the trampoline thing, I'm just like, what's wrong with my body, you know?
Yeah, I mean that could definitely, that one little incident, you know what I mean, could either like strain your muscles or sprain your ligaments or your joints or something like that. And I mean, unless you really get after it and kind of like do something about it, I mean, it just kind of snowballs after that. Little muscle, I mean, you start to form adhesions, like scar tissues in here, and that kind of contributes to your muscles and your skin like not gliding over each other. That causes pain, that causes you not want to move against the pain, and your body compensates in the opposite direction, and just everything just kind of goes out of whack.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
But the good thing about it is you knew you had to do something.
Yeah, I started to feel myself just like getting lazy and not wanting to do certain things.
Yeah, that's what happens too. After a while, you just kind of quit doing your regular activities, mm-hmm. and you just kind of don't want to do stuff, and then your body gets stiffer and stiffer. And telling some of my patients, I know you're not quite my age or anything like that, but I mean, any anytime after, you know, your mid-30s or something like that. I mean, people really need to evaluate what they're doing and how you're going to get along when you're like 70.
Mm-hmm.
Like I...
As soon as I hit, I was like 31, and I'm 31 and a half. I'm like, what happened 6 months, you know?
With the schooling that I have and stuff like that, I mean, that's almost even worse than like being your own doctor on Google. You know
yeah.
I mean? Like, because like you notice, you read these things in your physiology books, like your eyesight starts to get bad after 25 and stuff like that. And I was 27, I was just like, wow, I don't see as well as I did last year.
Yeah, you start questioning like,
yeah,
it really is true.
Last, just how quick life does go.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's pretty tight.
I actually can feel it in my lower back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right out here on the side, this
where it feels like a tickle.
Yeah. It's probably because there's a lot of just pain right here, and it's your brain doesn't know what to think about it.
I was like, well, it tickles.
I
was thinking the same
on.
Thing. I was like, well, yeah. Watching some weird show the other day.
Where were you watching that?
I was at the house and it was on TV.
Oh, okay.
And I fell asleep. I woke up too. I was like, what is that noise? I fell asleep watching Dateline.
Dateline.
So whatever came on after Dateline.
Oh, okay, whatever was on after Dateline.
Mm-hmm.
I thought you were going to tell me that you fell asleep and started dreaming about what was on television.
Probably. I mean, that's not that uncommon.
Some ropey strain muscles up there. Just let me know if anything's too much, like I said.
Mm.
Oh, this one's a lot tighter on this side. Is that what you said?
Uh-huh.
Something to the point of that.
Yep.
Yeah, I can feel it deep down, like these joints on this side just don't have a lot of give to them.
I'm just kind of relieved that everything's coming together.
What's that?
I'm relieved that everything's coming together. Finally, oh. This has, it's been a process.
I'm sure. And anything with changing hands of a house, remodeling, anything,
yeah.
The house is so much work. So much paperwork involved. A lot of stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, that's where we're at right now, is this bathroom.
And it doesn't help that, you know, if you know, you're trying to remodel or people are trying to build at this time. And I mean, I feel so bad for people that took bank money to
it's
build
expensive.
A house. And then all of a sudden, like, these houses are three times more
yeah.
to build. And, like, their projects are on hold because they can't, like, they're out of money. It's terrible.
Yeah.
It's terrible.
Yeah, on my right side. I'll fall asleep there. Okay.
Yep. Up here. Good. Bottom hip slides out a little bit closer towards me. Cool. Good. Hands right on your elbows, right there on your chest. Good. You okay like that?
Yeah.
This one on top. There you go. Okay, nice deep breath in. And out.
Wow. Nice.
Yeah, that was like your whole spine right there. Okay, now pull your chin up to your chest like that. Good. Oh, that was a good one too. Okay, go face down.
I'm gone in my mouth.
No worries. I have this ongoing joke with one of my other patients because she had a mint in her mouth or Tic Tac or something like that at one time. And we just joked that we almost killed her. We really didn't, just to get that on record, but it's just like we kind of was like, you know, it's funny if it were, you went to a chiropractor like a Tic Tac. Dyslexic until you become a chiropractor.
I feel like that in dentistry too.
It's always like, yeah, you have to look at somebody and be like, this is, you know, you're looking at your mirror image and
yeah.
you want to say right side, left side like it's yours, but it's.
Oh, nice. Makeup to work because I look like garbage this morning.
Take taking vacation, we always have this concept where it's going to be nice and relaxing and stuff, but it's just like so much work to get there, and you're running around the whole time, and it's really like you need another week to just kind of recover when you get back.
Right.
So much better. So just so much relief.
My sister's blowing my phone up.
Big one.
We should have recorded this one.
We did.
This one's a good one.
We did. That's the last one. We'll give you a little tug back here. Just a little stretch.
It feels so good.
I know, this is such a good adjustment. It's nice whenever you can feel it all.
Yeah,
it
down
back.
In the right, yeah.
All right, how you doing?
Good.
Good?
Yeah.
That's a chill.
Wow, that's so much better.
Yeah, you doing her good?
Yeah.
It's been a couple weeks.
I know, I messed up on so many air mattresses.
Oh man, that's the worst.
Well,
not sleeping in your own bed is...